Hey guys, Jeff Barber here again for RC Universe. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new RCGF 60cc rear exhaust engine. I had this engine running on this Stegall Hobbies test stand earlier, and it wasn't running quite right. I did some investigation. I found a couple of things. There was some debris in the carburetor inlet screen, so I took care of that. And then I also found that the port for the diaphragm pressure, the port off of the engine to give the carburetor fuel or carburetor pressure to operate the diaphragm, that port was mostly blocked. So I cleaned that out, took care of it, got the screen cleaned out. So we're gonna try running it again and see how she does today. So hang on, let me get her fired up. I got, it's gonna take a little bit because I don't have any fuel in the fuel line here, so it's going to take a little bit, but bear with me, we'll get her running. So we're going to start with the choke on, and we'll get some ignition hooked up. All right, we got power. Oh, I've already got better fuel flow. She's drawing like really well now. Choke off.
Thank you.
think I backed the idle down a little too far. That definitely made all the difference for getting the engine to run properly. Again, the port on the reed block for getting diaphragm pressure for the fuel pump was plugged, and so it wasn't getting proper pressure to the diaphragm and diaphragm fuel pump in the carburetor. And then there was some debris in the inlet screen inside the carburetor for the fuel inlet. So cleaned both of those out, and wow, the engine is running just absolutely perfect. Idling, I'm getting it down. Even right now, it's got not even an hour on it, and I've got the idle down at about 1800 RPM, which is where they recommend it to be. And then with this Falcon 23.8 prop on here, I am getting 6,200 RPM on the top side. Again, decibels at idle, we're about 100 decibels, right 2 feet behind the exhaust, and at 20 feet or so, we're roughly 80 decibels. Of course, that's going to go up as the volume increases when the engine is at half or full throttle. But I can't run that right now because it's got spring-loaded throttle. But I think the noise is going to be right in range with any of the other engines in this category, 60cc. So I don't think there's anything to worry about there. So fit and finish on the engine is really nice. It looks good. And man, it just runs really nice. I started with the carburetor settings that they recommend in the manual at 3 on the high range, 1.5 on the low, and just dialed them in a little bit from there. She's still a little bit rich, but I'm okay with that. Fuel, I'm running a 91 octane ethanol and ethanol-free gas. It's a non-oxygenated, and I'm using a synthetic two-stroke oil, running it at 30-1 mixture. Yeah, it's a little bit messier than it could be, but I don't like to run my engine short on oil either. So that's going to pretty much wrap it up for this one. That's a nice engine. I like it and can't wait to see how it does in the air. Stay tuned. I will have another review coming yet this summer, hopefully. And it's going to be powering a new giant scale decathlon coming from Seagull Models. So keep an eye out for that. For now, we've got a really good running engine, and I hope you guys like my video and my review. And from my front yard and my shop to you guys, we'll see you next time.